So here I am on the table. I'm digging inside. See? Did you miss Ghana? So good. Let me show you how you cut fufu, okay? You go like this. You press your two finger in like this. You cut it. That's how you cut fufu, okay? Yes. If you don't know how to cut it, that's how you cut it. So dip in and go. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you love this video of palm nut soup and fufu, or abankwen and fufu, or gekudesi with fufu, whatever you call it. Hope you love this video. If you do, please don't forget to give me a big thumbs up, share, and subscribe. Bye-bye. Hello, lovely people. Welcome back to my channel once more. I hope you all are doing good. I am doing fine by God's grace. So in today's video, we are going to be making palm nut soup, Ghanaian palm nut soup. We are going Ghanaian way. So let me show you the ingredients I have here for the soup, okay? I have here goat meat already washed in a pot about to season. And I have here my fresh onion and fresh tomatoes and the garlic here, ginger here, and the scotch bonnet pepper, the red one. I also have here my garden egg and the habanero pepper, the orange color. And I have your okra. I have your paste tomato. Paste tomato is a choice. We add it in our soup, especially Togolese, but it's a choice. Ghanaian normally use fresh one. I don't know if some of them use paste as well, but it just gives a beautiful color. We also have your anise seed. We have your salt. We also have your seasoning cube. We have your cut fish. It's here. We also have your the palm nut itself. The one I'm using, it's called praise. Praise. Let me remove my hand so you can see. It's called praise. It's what I'm going to be using. I might end up using 1.5 or 1 or 2. Yes. So it's a choice. And take any amount of the stuff that you know it's gonna be good in your soup, enough in your soup. Like I said, the onion and the fresh tomatoes and the paste, it just makes the soup thick and very tasty and beautiful. So without much wasting time, I'm going to be turning on my stove. I turn on my stove here, and then please, before I put my camera down for me to go and season my stuff. If today it's your first time stopping by, please don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell in case I upload new video, then you'll be able to watch it. So right now, I'm going to bring in my NutriBullet and put the stuff in and blend it. So right now, I'm going to be blending my stuff, which is the scotch bonnet pepper, the anise seed, you can see inside going on, and I have my ginger in, the onion, and the garlic. Everything is in there. The fresh tomatoes, I'm going to be adding me later, because this one I'm going to use them to blend, to season the meat, okay? That's why I'm going to blend all those ones separate, and the fresh tomatoes to blend separate and add into the soup. So here I have my onion, the white onion that I'm going to put it in. I also have fish that is baking in the oven. That's why I didn't show you yet. I'm a mackerel fish baking and pompano fish baking as well, which I'm going to be adding in this, okay? So I'm going to be blending this one. It's my blended stuff that I'm going to pour inside the meat. I'm going to pour it inside everything in. Yes, I'm not going to be reaching inside because I'm going to be putting my fresh tomatoes inside like that and blend it and pour it on it. So in this case, if it is my country or my other half country, Togoli, you know Togo, yes, we normally add this thing, the paste tomatoes, we mix it with the palm nuts, or the fresh one, both of them, with the palm nuts, we mix it with it, with water, and then we cook it aside, separately, and then when it's done, then we pour it on the meat, or we put the meat inside. That's how we do it, okay? We put the meat inside on the side. But Ghanaian, will do their fresh tomatoes. They will blend it with the stuff and put it on meat. Yes, they will put it on the meat. So I'm going to be adding my seasoning cube inside at this time. And then I'll also add my salt inside. Okay. Then I'll stir it. Now I'm going to go in with my fresh tomatoes. That's how Ghanaians do it. They put everything. They even blend it with other stuff together. Yes. So you can do it anyhow. You know, it's good. Then my paste tomatoes will go with the praise, the palm nuts. So I'm want to add some water. The water is here. My water added and let the meat cook. Yes. Let the meat cook. I can even add more water to let it cook. Yes. This time I'm going to be adding my catfish because the catfish is hard. So I'm going to be adding it inside. No, some of them add all the meat into the one it's on the stove that is cooking. It's a hard one. It's good for you to add your palm nuts butter, or the way you dilute it, then you add it into the meat on the fire. So some of them add all their meat in the pot before putting everything in, but at this case I will go with the hard meat, like the hard fish. Like this codfish, like this is very hard, ready fresh and washed. It's very hard, so I'm gonna let it cook with it. Then the crab's supposed to go, but I'll wait a little because the crab is not that hard. So I'm going to wait on for the crab, and then I'm going to be mixing the palm nuts and come and pour it inside. Okay, so now I'm about to mix my palm nuts with hot water or warm water, any water that your hand can go in. My tap water, it's very hot. If you open it, oh, you will see the steam. So here I'm opening my palm nuts, the palm nut butter. I'm opening it. This thing is very sharp, so I'm going to shoot it away. And then take my pan butter, I put it inside the bowl. So at this time, I'm going to be adding a little bit from here. I'm going to be adding some from this one, this. Let me put it inside. This one too is still good. Okay. Put it inside, put it away. I'm going to be adding some from this one. And then the remaining one, put it in the container and cover it and put it in the fridge, which I'm going to do later. So let me show you. I use my warm water. So this is the place I add the tomato paste inside. Mix it with it. I remember in back home those days, if we are doing it from a tribe, we use so like that. Then we're going to strain it. So I have my other bowl here with a strainer on top. So you see me, I'm going to be straining it like this. Okay, so you see it's inside. I'm going to put this one down. This my strainer is fine. It doesn't come out easy. It's good. So it makes everything that is not good stay in here. Now, as you can see, I'm straining it again the second time into the other bowl. Yes, it is good to strain it as many times together. Then let me show you. This is the second time, but you'll be surprised. Look inside. Very dirty. See? Very dirty. So I can go on and on to get all the dirt from under. That is how you do it, okay? Yeah, okay. So my meat is well cooked. I'm not going to add water because I want to add my palm nuts too before, like the palm butter into the meat before. So I'm going to add my crab now and let it cook. Yes, I need water, but I'm not going to add the water. I'm going to pour the palm butter inside before to see if I will add water or not. So I'm getting my palm butter ready. Off time again. Do it as many times. Doesn't matter. Do it as many times. So this is much better now. Let me show you. So see, this is much better now. But I still have a little bit there. So it's okay. You can do it as many times you want. Okay. Okay. So I am going to transfer inner into my soup. Yeah, let me transfer inner into my soup. Okay. Open my meat. Then I transfer it inside. So while you are transferring it, make sure you don't go all the way again. See? It's a bit dirty again. So you have to make sure you do it well. Mm-hmm. So I want to make my soup more, like a lot. So I make another palm butter on the side again. I'm pouring it inside. Yes, because I want it to be more. And I'm going to be adding water inside again. Okay? So let's see. The palm nut soup, it's cooking. Yeah, it's cooking very well. So since because this one, they don't cook it aside. So let me tell you, the only big difference in the Ghanaian and the Togolese or the Voltaire people, the only big difference is that we cook it, the Ewe people particularly, we cook it on the side. Well, we cook the meat on the side and we put the meat inside the palm nut soup that we cook on the side. But for them, they don't cook it on the side. They only mix it, dilute it with water, and strain it and put it on the meat that is in the pot. Okay, so that's the only big difference. So it's cooking for now. You have to let it cook for long and cook very well, because this one you're not cooking it separate. So here it's my mackerel fish. Yes, my mackerel fish here, and pompano fish. Yeah, ready bake them. Yes, I'm going to peel the skin now and get it ready to go in. So as the soup cook for a while, and I know it's cooked for like half and half, I'll go in with my okra and my garden egg. Garden egg is good in any soup, okra or in palm nuts or even any soup you can put it in. Yeah, garden egg is very good. It's like eggplants. So those are the stuff that left, and we're going to be finishing soon, okay? We're gonna wait on the soup to cook for a while. At this time, my soup is halfway done, so I'm going to be pouring all my fish that I wash inside. Yes, I'm going to be putting it inside, because if I pour it, it might splash on me. So I'm going to be pouring it inside, like putting it inside. Just like that. And so when you are cooking, it's good to know which one of the meat or the fish should go first, because some of them are soft. You don't want to put everything at the same time. Yeah, so you go in step by step, okay? So check inside my soup. And this abengkwen or palm nut soup, you can add any meat or fish of your choice inside, okay? So put anything inside. So we let it cook for halfway more again, then we'll put the rest of the stuff. I'll wait for a few minutes before adding the garden egg and other stuff again. So at this time, let's add our garden egg inside. Let me wash my hands, so because just remove my hand from water again. So adding my garden eggs at this time with my okra. Then I will let the pepper with the onion to go the last. They will be the last one to go. So the pepper will go in with the onion. Yes. At this time, here we have it. See, inside our pot. Yes. This one, we're going to be having some fufu, eh? Oh my God. Hope you love this palm nut soup. So we're going to be waiting now for a few minutes before we add the remaining one, then we're done. So we are going to be adding the last one inside, so which is the habanero pepper and the onion. Okay, So I'm going to be popping some and not popping some, okay? Because I don't want it to be too hot. Yeah, pop some in. Yes, I'm going to love the remaining one because I'm put my onion inside. Everything in. So there we have our pamba soup. Let's stir it. Let's stir it. See? There we have our pamba soup. Yes. See? Very delicious pamba soup. And very beautiful. So, and what is going on with pamba soup today? What are we eating with pamba soup? It's fufu. Here I have my cassava. You're going to be using different method for the fufu today. I'm waiting for my plantain to be arrived. Then I'll put them together and show you how we're going to do it, okay? So here it's my cassava and my plantain in the blender, as you can see. Yes, as the plantain arrived, I didn't show you. I'm going to be using this food processor to crush it, to make it a little bit, to crush, because if I use my NutriBullet, it will stop. It will not work. Like I said, if something is hard for the NutriBullet, it doesn't work. So I have to use this one to soften it, to make it small pieces before putting it, like chopping it small, before putting it into the NutriBullet to make it smooth. So here is my fresh plantain that I use inside. And I'm going to be, I have a blender, but I don't know that blender that I have. So I'm putting it now into the NutriBullet. Like I said, I add only a little bit of water. You don't want it to be too water that your fufu will be this thing. So you have to make it tiny water. Just add a little bit of water, okay? So at this time, I'm going to be blending it over there, okay? So my tin is blend already, my cassava and the plantain is blend. I'm going to be putting it in this, my glass bowl here. Supposed to be the deep one so that you'll be able to stir it after. But because I don't have the big, like the deep one, yeah, this is big, but it's not deep. So I'm going to use, because it's microwave safe. So I'm going to be pouring it in here like that. Like this. So I'm going to use a stick to remove inside. Have the container, pour it in, and I'll put in the microwave for about 8 to 15 minutes, depend on your microwave. Some people microwave go fast, some doesn't go fast. So yeah, so depend. So it should be 8 to 15 minutes, then you stir it. If yours is ready, 10 minutes is fine, okay? Yeah, so now I'm going to be putting it inside. Then after that, I'll transfer into this bowl to be able to stir it. Yes, because this is the... Okay. I'm going to use the lid itself to cover it well. So our fufu is that. Let's see how it's ever become so far. Okay. So see, this is how it is. But as you can see, I can see the inside is not cooked well. So I'm going to be mixing it in this bowl. Yes, in the glass bowl. It's hot, so that's why I'm using my napkin to hold it so that I can stir it. Okay, as you see me, I'm stirring me. Now I can hold it because it's getting cold now. I can hold the bowl. Yeah, inside was looking like it's not cool, but as long as you mix everything together, as long as you mix it, everything become perfect. See how it looks. So I'll just put it in for 2 minutes because it's very well cooked. See, oh, very nice. Yeah, so but I'm just gonna put it inside for 2 minutes and then I'll put it back again, okay? Stirring it, and for me, I see mine that it's soft already, and I don't want to add any water. As you can even see, it's perfect. Yeah, it's perfectly cooked. See, Yeah, so I don't want to add any more water into it. But I'm just going to put it in for 2 minutes for it to cook perfectly. So if you want, like this water, I'm washing my hand in. It does not has nothing wrong because you can use a little bit of water to sprinkle on it. Like I'll come to the sink like this. Just a little bit, just sprinkle on it. Don't add any water. That's all. So I'm going to put it back in the microwave now. Cover it back again. And I'll give it 2 minutes. So I'm bringing back my fufu now. See? It's well cooked. See? So I am going to be... So now I transfer water out, that one out, and I put new water here with my tampoli inside. The light is, so I'll be able to do it well and put it in the asanka. Yes. This one, it makes it easy for me to stay, see? See how beautiful the fufu is. Yes. So I'm going to be transferring it into the asanka. Then, okay, that's my asanka. The bowl is so hot. So there we have our fufu. Yes, I'm going to just rest it beautifully. Then the soup will go on it. So I'm going to, I wash my hand, but I'm going to dip my hand in again. Yes, then I'll just use my left hand to hold the tampoli. We call this one tampoli. And use my right hand to be placing me. See, that's how you do it. So put some water on the side, grab it like this, and put it on top like this. Grab it, yes, beautifully. See, that is how we do it. That's how we do it back home, like that. Now I can go fast for you guys to see it. Well, so if you are from Ghana, you will know how to do this. If you are, so I divided my fufu to two because I cannot finish that fufu. The rest is for the family. So yes, I do it nice again. Then I'm going to put my soup on the side. Yes, so there is my fufu, as you can see. Let me serve my own soup. Yes, as you can see, with everything. Look into the pots. Okay, see how I'm going to serve my food. Any fish, any meat, go in. Let's grab some fish. Check inside my pot here. Oh, my asanka. Which one? Let's grab some goat meat and some catfish. Let's grab some pepper. The oil is too much. In the meantime, I'm going to be taking the oil from on top of the soup. Yes, that oil can help you to cook your okra soup or anything else. Okay, so let me grab some okra at this time. Grab some okra. And so I have all that I need. Some mackerel. Yeah, serve some mackerel. So check it out. Here it's my fufu. Let's see at the table. Let's meet at the table. Okay, so here I am on the table. I'm digging inside. See? Did you miss Ghana? So good. Let me show you how you cut fufu, okay? You go like this. You press your two finger in like this. You cut it. That's how you cut fufu, okay? Yes. If you don't know how to cut it, that's how you cut it. So dip in and go. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you love this video of palm nut soup and fufu, or abankwen and fufu, or gekudesi with fufu, whatever you call it. Hope you love this video. If you do, please don't forget to give me a big thumbs up, share, and subscribe. Bye-bye.